What's going on YouTube? It's your boy Darren. I'm the Bow Tie Fragrance Guy. Looking good and smelling great is what I do. That's what this channel is all about. And today, I'm going to give you guys my first impression of the brand new release Dolce & Gabbana, the one, the intense version. Now, I'm pretty sure you all are familiar with the previous releases from this line, the EDT as well as the EDP. But again, we're going to talk about the intense today. And I'm going to give you guys, you know, as I always do, my 2 cents on this particular fragrance. This will just be like a first impressions. I'm not gonna go in depth with notes and things of that nature, but I just wanna give you guys my thoughts on it really quick, if you guys are cool with that. Before we get into that, I wanna give you guys my subscriber spotlight. So let's see, who do we have in the spotlight today? Today's subscriber spotlight comes from Duncan Spake. And Duncan wrote, "You are in my top 5 frag reviewers. I thought you had quit. It was my dumb that didn't hit the bell. The bell is rung. Looking forward to more. Cheers, Gary." Well, Duncan Spake, thank you so much for watching the last video and taking the time to comment. And a thank you, of course, for hitting the bell. Guys, if that's something you haven't done, please go ahead and do that. Hit that bell notification so that when I do release future content on this channel, of course, you'll know when it's coming out and you won't miss the videos, man. Come on, I need you guys' support. So go ahead and hit that bell. But again, Duncan, thank you so much for taking the time to comment. And as become customary here, this is for you, 2 sprays in the air. Man, some good stuff. Duncan, that was for you. Okay, guys, so you know how we do, you know how we get down. If you want to see what my thoughts are, know what my thoughts are on the newly released Dolce & Gabbana, the one intense, keep it locked right here. Okay, guys, I'm back. Thank you so much for staying tuned in. Let's go ahead and jump right into this fragrance. Now, here is the box for it. I can recall it's pretty reminiscent of the EDP version of this fragrance as it relates to the box. It has, it's black and it's written in gold letters. It says Dolce & Gabbana, the one, Eau de Parfum Intense. This is a 100 milliliter bottle, 3.3 fluid ounces. And has a little cool feature here on the back. Kind of looks like opening an envelope. Across the top here says Dolce & Gabbana, and you pull it this way to open it and get the fragrance out. Okay, but that's what the box looks like. Forget the box. No, I'm just kidding. Shout out to Big Beard. But this is what the fragrance actually looks like. All right, so it's in this black bottle. So it's very much a bottle that you can't see through this to really see how much juice you're gonna have left. But it's cool, I like the bottle. It's really sleek and sophisticated, again, just like the EDT and the EDP. Same bottle design, but again, it's just black. You cannot see through this at all. And just like the box, it's black with the gold writing down here. And of course, again, it says Dolce & Gabbana, the one. So again, I like the bottle presentation. It's very, very sleek, just like I like the bottles of the other two releases from this line. So enough about the presentation. Let's get into talking a little bit more about what's inside of the bottle. Now, I've already sprayed, but I'll give myself one fresh spray so I can remind myself here. So, first things first, to me, this is a almost complete total departure from the first two fragrances. There are slight nuances of the EDT and the EDP found in this one, but to me, this is a totally new fragrance. It really does a lot of different things from the previous two releases. Like, if you were in love with that, which like I was, I love the tobacco note in the EDT. I love the tobacco note in the EDP. There's no tobacco in this one. Now, there are some notes in here that kind of give you a vibe of tobacco. So after about 5 minutes, I start to kind of pick up on elements that remind me of the previous releases. But that's really about it, man. To me, this kind of goes in a totally different direction. And I have a fragrance that helps me describe what this fragrance, for the most part, really reminds me of. I heard anybody say this yet, but this fragrance reminds me a lot of Jazz Club from Replica. This fragrance reminds me a lot of Jazz Club. And when I looked it up, my hunch was right. They share very similar notes. Now, some of the notes are different, but there are notes in these two fragrances that actually do the same thing. You can have different accords, which are notes that are together, combined together, that create a certain vibe. And again, there's no tobacco in this, but there are some notes and accords in here that kind of remind you of tobacco. There are some resins in this, and although they're not listed as the same resins, there are resins in this as well. But again, they do have several notes that are the same. And, you know, so again, when I looked up the note breakdown, I said, oh, my hunch was right. That's why these two fragrances remind me a lot of one another. You kind of get, again, that vibe of tobacco in this one, although there's no tobacco listed. And there's also kind of a booziness about it. And, you know, I really, really like the way that it works. Again, if you know what this smells like, and you know, of course, what the EDP or the EDT smells like of Dolce & Gabbana 1, and you kind of combine those two, you have a really good idea of what this one smells like if you have not put your nose on it yet. I do believe there's a potential for folks that were diehard fans of the EDT and the EDP. If you were expecting a fragrance that was very, very similar to those previous releases, but just a little bit more heavier, maybe a little more dense, and lasts a little bit longer, you may be disappointed in this because, again, it doesn't really remind me a whole lot of those fragrances at all. Again, it's something totally new, but in my personal opinion, I like it. I think it's a true flanker of the previous releases. Unlike, you know, to me, Sauvage or in Bleu de Chanel, how you can tell it really kind of just intensified, for the most part, the fragrance with each release. This one, it kind of went in a different direction, and it's cool because I do feel there's enough elements of the previous two releases to say that it is related in some way, but I like the direction that they went, making this a more spicier, a little bit more sweeter fragrance. So when I spray this, again, I'm reminded a little bit of the previous releases, but again, it starts to remind me a lot of Jazz Club. There's a very, very spicy and very resinous accords that really come into play in the beginning of this. And really, really, they stay for the life of this. This is a really kind of sweet, resinous, spicy fragrance. But I really, really, really dig it. Now, I'll be back to do a full review on this once I've had a chance to really wear it. I wore it yesterday. And I will say when I applied it last night, when I got up this morning, I could still smell it. So I can tell you now that the longevity has improved. But again, being an EDP and a more intense version, it does sit a little bit closer to the skin. But again, that's cool. I think this is going to be a really, really sexy fragrance. I love Jazz Club, so I do like this one so far as well. So far, so good. This one retails for $98. You can't get the smaller size. I'm not sure what it costs, to be honest with you. I think it's like around $75 or something like that for the smaller bottle. But again, not bad. But again, I'll be back again to do a full review on this once I've had more time to spend with. Okay guys, that's my time. Thank you so much for taking the time out to watch this video. You guys could have been anywhere else in the world, but you're right here with me, and I sincerely appreciate that. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share these videos because I'm the Bowtie Fragrance Guy. I love to look good, and I love to smell amazing. So until next time, guys, keep looking good, keep smelling even better. I'll catch you on the flip side. Peace.